Millions and millions of mourners arrived in Rome and waited in lines for hours to be able to pray for a moment in front of the body of Pope John Paul the Great. Meanwhile, sensational news bounced from mobile phones to websites, from United States to Medjugorje to Rome. The Pope had been dead for about 4 hours, Saturday night, when Ivan Dragicevic, one of the six visionaries from Medjugorje, had his daily apparition in Boston, the city where he lives for part of the year. There it was 6:40 p.m. overseas on April 2nd. While Ivan was praying, as usual, looking at the Madonna, the beautiful young woman who has appeared to him every day since June 24, 1981, Pope John Paul II appeared on her left. According to Ivan, the Pope was smiling, he looked young and was very happy. He was dressed in white with a golden cloak. Our Lady turned towards him and the two, looking at each other, both smiled, an extraordinary, wonderful smile. The Pope continued ecstatic to look at the young woman and she turned to Ivan saying, "My dear son is with me." She didn't say anything else, but her face was radiant like that of the Pope who continued to look at her face. This news, as you can understand, made a great impression even reaching some people who are praying in St. Peter's about the poor mortal remains of Karol Wojtyła. Christians repeat every Sunday in the Creed, "I believe in eternal life." But the news of this apparition is truly an exceptional thing. Many turn up their noses because of a prejudicial hostility to the breaking of the supernatural. Our Lady of Medjugorje was, from the beginning, very determined in wanting to remind our generation of the reality of eternal life, of the definitive life which is true life. In fact, already on the second day of the apparitions, June 25, 1981, she reassured one of the girls, Ivanka, still distressed by the recent death of her mother, and then revealed her mother to her, close to Our Lady. Some of the visionaries testify that they were brought to see hell, purgatory and heaven, as the children of Fatima were also shown hell. But let us return to the canonization of the Pope who made the Pope John Paul II, who was a great contemplative, was instead profoundly open to the supernatural. As evidenced by his veneration for Sister Faustina Kowalska, one of the greatest mystics of the 20th century. Saint Faustina was canonized by Pope John Paul, and he also instituted the Feast of Divine Mercy that was to be the key to the reading of the 20th century, and of history as a whole. That the Pope's death took place precisely on this Feast of Divine Mercy is extraordinarily significant. It was a first Saturday of the month, the day on which, according to the pious practice established by the Virgin of Fatima, she herself calls those who entrust themselves to her. Under the pontificate of Pope John Paul II, Medjugorje had indeed become one of the grace-filled centers of the Christian world. Thank you for supporting my channel. Please like, comment and subscribe. May God bless you and keep you. Saint Pope John Paul the Great, pray for us. Our Lady, Queen of Peace, pray for us.